Hello everyone, my name is Miroslav and I'm a member of Technical Support Department here in ComAp. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to do a firmware upgrade. Let's assume that you are connected directly to your controller. And as a first step, we need to save our actual archive. We can do that by clicking File, Save As. GenConfig needs to read the current configuration from the controller. Okay, the archive is saved. And now you need to click File, Firmware Upgrade and Cloning, Firmware Upgrade Default Configuration. And as you can see in this table, you can find all imported firmwares in your computer. So you need to select appropriate one. So the latest firmware for my IntelliGen controller is IG-NTC-BB 4.1. So I need to select this one and click OK. Before I click OK, I would like to say that this archive is configured in Mint application, and after this firmware upgrade, the configuration will be in SPTM, as you will see later. Now the firmware is successfully upgraded, and as a first step, we need to change the current application from SPTM to Mint back again. So we need to open a default configuration this Mint application by clicking this icon, open file. Now we need to search for a default folder, which is typically in C, users, public documents, comma PC suite, GenConfig, archives, default. And in this folder, we can find all default configuration files for all imported firmwares. So let's search for IntelliGen Basebox Mint application in firmware version 4.1 and click open. Now we have an archive with the default configuration and Mint application, and as a next step, we need to import the original configuration, which means import inputs and outputs and set points. And we can do that by clicking File, Import Configuration Wizard, then selecting the original archive that was saved by us into this folder. So let's select this one, click open, and follow the procedure by clicking next button. After successful import of configuration, all you need to do is just check inputs and outputs and then write the configuration into your controller. And that's it. Thanks for watching.